As a highly requested video, I'm gonna be doing an apartment tour for you guys today. A kind of short one. I'm gonna try to keep it as short as possible, but a lot of you guys requested in seeing my apartment and my whole layout and how I built it. I moved in early February of 2020. And so it's only been maybe like, I think like 8-9 months or something like that. So I'm very much overdue for an apartment tour. So I want to take you guys through my place, show you everything. I'm gonna try to link all of the furniture down below. When you guys see something that you like, I'll do my best. But we're gonna be doing that. I'm gonna be talking about kind of also where I'm gonna go from here. So let's do this. Welcome to today's new video. So to start off real quick, this is a one bedroom apartment. It's about like 730 square feet. Let me just get out of my face real quick. Boom, right there. So it's a decent size. And I'll actually tell you how much I'm paying in rent. So I am paying about like almost $1,900 a month for this place in total with everything, like with parking and everything, all that good stuff. Not including utilities, just like the main things related to this apartment, I'm paying almost $1,900 a month. So it's kind of steep up there, but it's what was the best in the area and what made sense is the location. And other apartments are going even more expensive than that. We're talking about like 2K. I was like, ooh. Okay, so let's start off this apartment tour. And I'm actually gonna start with my office area type thing. Yeah, let's do that.
But I gotta get to the money, baby. We both love these honeys, yeah. Once I'm finished with my job, baby girl, yeah, I'm on my way, yeah. I'ma copy that new purse if I see it up on display. And you know I don't say things just to say things, yeah. Never felt, never had no love like you.
So this is my office layout right here, my desk layout. And you guys can see it is a mess. It's kind of a mess and it's kind of organized at the same time, but for the most part, it's a freaking mess, right? This is just the way it is. I like to keep things where they're at so I know where they're at and everything so I don't move too many things around. But this is the book that I'm currently reading right now. Deep Work. This kind of sucks, to be honest. That's my MacBook Pro that I use. It's my Bluetooth wireless keyboard and stuff like that. My Tesla key. It's a must. Definitely a must. Yeah, so this is a IKEA built desk right here. And you'll notice like basically most of my apartment is like 90% IKEA. This chair, this is the CEO chair right here. This is my go-to chair, very, very comfortable. I love the form of it. I love the look and color of it. Definitely recommend this chair, but this chair was definitely expensive as hell. So yeah, that's that. But I have my desk light, and then also these are my studio lights for when I do any, you know, my YouTube videos for, you know, my sit down usual tutorial videos and stuff like that. So to get my face all pretty, that's what I use. All right, so that's where I got. I spent about almost like, I think $150 on the desk itself. Spent about over $200 on the chair, so that's funny. The chair is more expensive than the desk. It is what it is, right? And then you'll see this messy area right here. There's a lot of like private things that I have in this area, like files and stuff, but it's just kind of like a storage box area and I have a printer on top of that. If you guys follow me on my Instagram, you'll know this is my famous mirror. This is my go-to mirror. I love this mirror so much. It's a very, very nice mirror. I don't know how I figured out how I hung it on the wall, but it worked out in some way. But love this mirror. Very, very nice mirror. Also from IKEA. I think this one was like $150 as well. Don't quote me on these prices because I literally just don't know exactly the numbers. But of course, I'm going to link everything down below so you guys can see and check this out. But this is my mirror. Moving on to the living room now. This is my entire living room right here. And you'll see that I have a big theme about whites, grays, and blacks. I like to keep it very modern and minimalistic. We'll start off with this table right here. So this coffee table is from IKEA. Somewhere in the $200 range is where I got it from. I just don't remember what else like the pricing is, but it just seems about right. You best believe that all the plants in my place are definitely completely fake. They are definitely not real. So just enjoy these plants for how they look and not that they're alive or anything. I know that there's a certain name to this couch right here, but I can't remember what the couch is. But I know that I spent a good amount of money on this couch. I think I spent almost $500 on this couch. Again, probably the wrong price, but it's not the most comfortable couch in the world, but it gets the job done. I really like the color and the contrast of it against the wall. So I'm definitely a fan of these. And then these little, you know, pillows right here, that actually didn't come with the couch. I got this from like a bed set and I just kind of threw it on there. This blanket I got from my mom's house. What can I say, right? Now this canvas painting right here, this is from actually Amazon. I got this from Amazon. I think it was like $60 or $50, something like that. And I wanted something that was gonna contrast my wall. I didn't want too many like blacks, whites, and grays and stuff like that. I wanted some color that kind of matches, and not matches, but contrasts with everything. So I got that nice little wall art thing. So it kind of, you know, has something going on, some kind of color, something that's not as depressing. You feel me? You feel me? So it brings a little bit of life into it. This rug is also from IKEA as well. I like that it's a nice little furry woolly blend against the ground right here. This wood floor, definitely when I have a house, it's gonna be wood floor. But I got this for, I think it was like $50 on IKEA. Let's hope I can find all these links on IKEA for you guys. I'm gonna do my best, but link in the description if you guys wanna cop any of these. Of course, obviously this is not an affiliate link. This is just for your information. Moving on, I have this floating console right here for my TV setup. And yes, it's a floating console. You see, it is literally hanging off that wall. Let me tell you, this was a bitch to get on. Me and my friends tried to get this on, and it definitely isn't my most perfect or proud piece of work that I've done, but it's up there for now. This is also from IKEA, and it was cheap as hell. You can see like the freaking door handles are not even to the shelving. It's a mess. That kind of pissed me off, but it is what it is. It's up there, it works. I got my Alexa over here to help me do anything that I need, my slave work and stuff like that. Of course, we gotta have the Nintendo Switch on deck when the homies want the hands on Fortnite or something like that. And then I have a TCL flat screen TV. This is a, I believe this is a 50 inch. Yeah, I believe it's a 50 inch 4K TV. And then I have some LED and lights in the background. I also put some LED lights on my desk too. So you'll see, Alexa, turn on all the lights. See that? So those are my LED lights so far. And this is my TV setup. Again, this was all a mess to put on. TV wall mount though, I did get installed by Amazon. Amazon does provide a service where they can come in and actually install things for you. So that's really, really cool. Thank you, Amazon, for getting this in for me. Moving on, we have this lovely like four stack box wall hanging thing, this floating wall shelf. I built this myself. I built all the boxes and stuff by myself, and I hung it all by myself as well. This one wasn't too bad of a project. This was a little tedious, but it still got it done. And you can see there's some missing space right there because I still need to fill in some things here. But for the most part, it is pretty much done as well. I just need to figure out what I want to put in these empty cellar that you got there. I need that one and I need that one. I don't know what I'm gonna do. Of course, we got some fake plant action. You know, we can't go wrong with that. That's a must. And then in this shelf, I got all of my books that I've read so far, and some of my favorite books as well. Power of Broke, 4-Hour Work Week, Dichotomy of Leadership. I'm missing a few books. I let some of my friends borrow it. So there's some books that are missing here, but those are my go-to right now at the moment. Got some family pictures right here. And then shout out to my anime fans right here. If you know who this is Kakashi Hatake from Naruto. So shout out to my anime fans. I got this from Amazon, and then I got this Funko Pop. That's what it's called. Yeah, Funko Pop. Got this from my brother. He gave it to me as a gift. And then we got a bunch of empty space right here. So that's basically the living room so far. Let's take you guys to the kitchen area. Now, what really sold me about this apartment was actually these hanging chandelier light things. I really, really like that touch. Definitely think it gives it a much more high elegant modern vibe to it. So this is my whole entire kitchen setup right now. Very, very basic. Don't know where I got these chairs from, because my mom bought them and I just took them from her house without her asking, or without asking her. So sorry, mom, but these chairs were the only thing that matched my apartment at the time. I got some other ones from IKEA, but I didn't really like them. The cool thing about my apartment is they have like a trash valet. So I live in the upper floors, so I don't want to go out at night and go downstairs to the dumpster. So they have a trash valet where I put this outside my door and then they pick up the trash for me. So that's kind of nice. A little toaster over there. And then this is my stove. I definitely keep things pretty much clean throughout my apartment. Like the way you see it now is basically how it always looks. I'm not a messy man. You know, some dudes out here trash in their place, trash in their car, trash in their apartment, stuff like that. Not I. I like to keep a pretty clean place. The only thing that will probably be like the most messiest is gonna be my office desk area, because I like literally have so many things I need to do and paperwork and stuff like that. So it's like, that's probably the only thing that's messy, but literally everything else, my room, living room, kitchen will most likely always be clean. Okay, ask my friends about that. Shout out to More Fake Plants. Got this plant from Amazon for like 50 bucks. This is where I leave my gym bag most of the time. And this empty space right here, I was gonna fill it with more furniture, but I'm actually getting a dog in a few weeks. So I'm gonna leave this area for like his crate and everything and leave this as his home area. So that's why I'm gonna keep this area empty until I get my little chow chow. Basic shoe rack box area. We got the fridge, rice cooker, that's a must. And then candles, this candle is the best candle in the world. Mahogany, teak wood, something like that. Bed Bath & Beyond, shout out to y'all. So this is the good stuff right here. A lot of cabinets. You see, they definitely gave me a lot of cabinets, a lot of storage space, so I love that. Then I got this like kind of a pantry area. This is where I keep all of my food. Let's move on to my bathroom. Boom, bathroom. This is my bathroom. It's pretty basic, pretty straightforward, nothing crazy, but it is a nice clean bathroom. Just got a few things on the counter, cabinets, gray mats, nice little toilet, little shelving area for whatever, and then pretty much it, pretty basic. Now you see how decorative kind of like my living room is, and is not very decorative. And you should see my room. My room is very much not as decorative as my living room. My room is pretty damn bland, I'll tell you that. So here, walking into my room, very, very basic, got a laundry basket right here. That's my bed. I have this thing that this little, a blanket, I guess, I don't know, some kind of sheet, a decorative sheet that I'm just hanging up there. Shout out to Kilo Jules for recommending that to me and finding something like that. So I put it in my room. It used to be my living room, but now I put it in my room just to give it a little bit of color, but it really is kind of irrelevant. And then got a nice little shoe rack here, all my shoes. Shout out to Balenciaga, shout out to Nike, whatever. And then I have a nice little walk-in closet area. So you see, so all my clothes, you know how it would be. Shout out to Louis Vuitton, you know how it is. What else is cool about this apartment is that it comes with a nice balcony. Look at this. Look how much space is in this balcony. An amazing view. This balcony is huge, but I don't have anything out there. I probably should get like a barbecue out there or like some tables or something like that. But I definitely think since I'm gonna be living here, probably for the next somewhere between like four to 7 months or something like that. I think I should get some kind of balcony furniture, something like that. Now, if you guys aren't following me on my Instagram, you guys should. It's just Kevin Pacman. Very, very easy to find me. But if you've been following me on my Instagram, you know that I've been house hunting. So I'm only gonna be living here
until February. That's when my lease ends. But depending if I find a house or not by that time, I'm gonna have to actually push it till later. But the game plan here is to somehow find a house between January and July of next year. That's what I'm hoping for. I can't really pinpoint a time because I was so set on buying a house in like January, February, but it looks like it's probably gonna take longer than that. This next house that I'm buying next year is gonna be more of not like my forever home, but it's gonna be an investment property as like a rental property. So I'm gonna live in it for a few years, rent out the rooms, and then like when I find another house, I'm going to buy that and then rent out that house, that the first house that I'm gonna buy next year, right? So that's my game plan. So because of that, that I'm going into it with a kind of investment mentality, I can't find a good deal right now. You know, I'm working with a realtor right now, but I can't find a really good deal. And then the housing market right now, all the prices are really, really high. Interest rates are really, really low. That's great, but there's low inventory of houses and there's high demand of people who wanna buy houses. So that's the problem right now. So depending on how things go next year, maybe things will be a little bit better, or at least at the end of this year. But I'm not in no rush to buy anything right now. I just want to take my time, do this right. So I'm just hoping that I can get a house next year. That's the game plan, preferably before the summer. So that's kind of what I'm doing. I'm going to be doing a lot of house shopping, a lot of house hunting. And then we'll see what 2021 brings for us. But that is the game plan. So I'm going to be living in this apartment for a while until I find a house. I might have to actually renew my lease until I do find a house, depending on, you know, how long that takes. So a lot of factors going in, but it is very, very exciting to be house hunting. And it's crazy how like this year I moved into my own apartment and now I'm gonna be buying a house next year. Is kind of crazy. Like 25 years old doing this is a blessing, and I'm very, very grateful to be in this position that I'm in my life. And I just want to keep moving forward. Just want to take a step forward each and every day. So that is the game plan right now. Don't have much to do as far as work for today. It's Wednesday. I'm going to probably go train. I have a couple of coaching calls I have to do. But that's the game plan. I actually have to look at a house today too. Thank you guys for watching this apartment tour. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I will catch you guys in the next one. Like the video, comment, and as always, go make that money. Peace.